We want to solve the trig equation cosine 2x equals cosine x on the interval from 0 to 2 pi, where the interval is closed on 0 and open on 2 pi, meaning it includes 0 radians but does not include 2 pi radians. And the issue with this equation is we already have one trig function, but one angle is 2x and the other angle is x. So we're going to have to use a double angle identity to perform a substitution on the left side of this equation, so all the angles will be x. Looking at our double angle identities for a cosine, notice we have three options, but since it's normally best to have a trig equation in terms of one trig function, we're going to replace cosine of 2x with 2 cosine squared x minus 1. So let's go ahead and perform that substitution here on the left. Again, we're going to have 2 times cosine squared x minus 1 equals cosine x. Notice our equation now is in form of a quadratic, so we're going to go ahead and set this equal to 0 and then see if it factors. So we'll subtract cosine x on both sides. So we'll have 2 cosine squared x minus cosine x minus 1 equals 0. The 0 came from the right side here where we have cosine x minus cosine x. Now let's go ahead and see if this factors. The factors of 2 cosine squared x will be 2 cosine x and cosine x. And then the second positions must come from the factors of negative 1 so that the inner product and outer product have a sum of negative 1 cosine x. So if we put a negative 1 here, we'll have negative 2 cosine x, and a positive 1 here, we'll have a positive cosine x, which does give us a sum of negative 1 cosine x. So now that we have this factored, if either of these factors are equal to 0, this equation will be true. So either 2 times cosine x plus 1 equals 0, or cosine x minus 1 equals 0. If we solve this for cosine x, we'll have cosine x equals subtract 1 divided by 2, it's negative 1 half. Here we'll add 1, cosine x equals 1. So to determine the values of x that satisfy these two equations, we'll use a unit circle. Remember, cosine theta is equal to x. So we'll look for x coordinates on the unit circle of negative 1 half and positive 1. Well, x is negative in the second and third quadrants. Here's an x coordinate of negative 1 half. And here's an x coordinate of negative 1 half. So cosine x is equal to negative 1 half at 120 degrees or 2 pi over 3 radians, as well as 240 degrees or 4 pi over 3 radians. And then to determine where cosine x equals 1, notice there's an x coordinate here, and this is why it's important to remember the interval in which we're trying to solve this equation. Again, the interval was from 0 to 2 pi, where it was closed on 0 and open on 2 pi, so we're looking for 0 degrees or 0 radians as the other solution. Let's go ahead and record this on the previous screen. And here we had x equals 2 pi over 3 or 4 pi over 3 radians. And here we had x equals 0 radians. And I think we'll stop here for this video. I hope you found this helpful.